Welcome to CACE International. I'm Fikisha Kumbo. We have a dynamic show for you this evening. I don't know if you've heard about it, but there have been a number of bodies discovered in Lower Manhattan in an African burial site. And we have two gentlemen here who are going to tell us all about what the community is doing about preserving that site. We have Mr. Elombe Brath, chairman of the Patrice Lumumba Coalition, and Mr. Noel Pointer, who's a jazz violinist, and he's also the chairman of this committee to preserve this ancient burial site. Welcome, gentlemen.
Welcome. Thank you.
How you doing?
I'm doing all right. Now, I want to hear everything. Tell me the who, the what, the where, the when, the why, the how about this burial site. You know, when did all this happen? What happened?
Well, it seems like last fall, as the construction company was excavating for this new building to be put up at, well, it's actually between Broadway and Elk Street and Reed and Duane in Lower Manhattan, just a couple of blocks away from City Hall, they discovered that they had disturbed the gravesite and had broken up some coffins. And of course, that brought immediate help, a halt rather, because once you found out there was bones there, you had to figure out what was happening. But they already had known that that was what had been known as a Negro burial ground. It seems that what had happened in the 18th century, in the 1700s that is, that this particular area was designated for Africans to be buried in, because at that time they were not allowed to be buried within the confines of the city. So what they did is they disposed of the bodies outside the city limits. Of course, years later, as real estate interests started to become more and more concerned with developing Lower Manhattan, they obliterated the fact that on the map they said Negro burial ground and then built over that area. And so that perhaps under City Hall, and it's a good indication that this is true, there are thousands of bodies, because we're talking about a gravesite that was in use from 1712 to 1792. That's 80 years.
A whole century.
That's 80 years. And we talk about 80 years at a time when you had a very short life expectancy. And when they looked at some of the bodies that have been discovered, 40 to 45% of them were children, you know, and most of them died from stress. That's what they've been able to ascertain. So we have a major discovery that is now in a contradiction with the construction company trying to finish their building, but now the scientific people are trying to get their work through, and the community now becoming concerned because it was a sacrilege, you know, to desecrate our graveyard where our ancestors lived.
Yeah. Now, we have a little map here that will show us the general section of where this is taking place.
Right.
Now, describe where it is again.
It's on Broadway, between Broadway and Elk, and between Duane and Reed Street in Lower Manhattan. The site is located one block north of Chambers Street, and right around the corner from City Hall.
Can anybody see it? Can anybody go in?
Yeah, it's fenced off, and you can go down and look in the construction site. You know, they have the little portholes where you can look in. And if you look down, you'll see the archaeologist tents that are set up where they're working in just about round the clock now. You know what the interesting thing I'd like to add to what Elombe was saying is that this isn't just any building that's going up. This is being hailed as the largest civilian government real estate project in the nation, okay? This is a building that's going to be 34 stories high, that is going to house the Internal Revenue Service and the Environmental Protection Agency. They have several unannounced tenants, federal tenants. So this is a very, very big deal. There are going to be about 4,200 federal employees working in this building. Okay, so this is not just any building that is that we're uprooting our ancestors for. Another point is that this is the only black urban burial ground from the Revolutionary War era ever discovered. And it's also the only American cemetery from that era ever to be excavated. What the archaeologists were telling us when we went down was that because of the various burial customs that are being found, and some of the skeletons were found with filed teeth in an African tradition and custom that lets us know that many of these people were first-generation African-Americans who lived in Lower Manhattan and worked in Lower Manhattan. This would be the equivalent to us going to dig up the pilgrims' graves.
Oh.
Okay?
Now, how many people you think are down there?
The original estimate is 20,000.
Get out of here.
Yes, because the original burial ground was from 5 to 6 acres. As of April 13th, there was something like 300 and, what did they tell us?
About 316, I think, something like that. They had actually.
So wait a minute, you're telling me that with that many thousands of bodies, they're probably under City Hall, all down in that area.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, the whole Lower Manhattan, the whole municipal structure is resting on our people's remains. Well, that we can't do anything about. What is happening here in front of our eyes now is that these bodies are now being, you know, exhumed, taken away to Lehman College, where the anthropologists and the forensic, you know, the forensic anthropologists and the archaeologists can go over them to try to do their work. But at the same time, we have a contradiction because we feel that the ground was designated as an African burial ground. And that was the first insult, that we had to be buried outside the city. And then after that, they then went beyond even what they had first initiated. That is, that area was designated for our people. And then they went and put other buildings up over them. And now, even in death, the idea is to remove the remains. So one of the major questions is where will the bodies be reinterred? Now, Mayor Dinkins had opted for reinterment, but there's nobody really talking that much about, after they say that, to make it happen. And a couple of weeks ago, we had a word that we had felt that they were going to pour concrete, and if they did that, that all this would be lost.
Yes.
Well, they said they didn't intend to do that. They had started to pour some, but a group, you know, besides ourselves, Brother Sonny Carson and the Committee to Honor Black Heroes, along with the Black Watch Movement, all descended on the site and stopped the work.
Okay.
So from that time, we've been having meetings with the General Service Administration, along with the construction company and other, and the people from Lehman College, over our concerns about what is going to be the future of the site, and particularly what is going to happen to those bodies that they have taken out already, and those who they're planning to take out.
Now, we got a shot here that your brother Kwame did of archaeologists down on their stomachs, looking at these bodies and probably coming up with some of the things that you're just telling us about now. Would they take all of the bodies and take them to Lehman? Is that what they want to
do? Well, yes, that's what they're planning on doing. They're planning on doing a lot of scientific experimentation, taking DNA samples from hair, doing things.
What would that tell us?
It will tell us things like the diet of the slaves. They can tell by stretch marks on the skeletal frames as to what kind of occupation certain of them have had, who, for instance, might have ridden a horse, and information like that. The sad thing is that while the African-American community is in a very compromised position, because this building project is already so far underway, the community is not really having a say in the research. You know,
okay. who's got the research?
Well, Lehman College does, but I think.
And why Lehman College?
Well, that's a good question. That's a very good question. We feel that there needs to be some traditionally or historically a black university or college brought in to have a relationship with Lehman College on, you know, gathering this data.
Is that one of the things your committee
is
proposing?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
While there have been individuals who have been called in by the federal government, There is no real relationship between a black university or a college, mm-hmm. which I think is a necessary step to take. Because for one thing, there are a lot of questions that arise from the findings that, you know, we've heard the archaeologists talk about that many of the white scientists just won't know about.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
when you start talking about
you need to know something
African
about our history
customs,
to know
what, yes,
yeah,
what
customs.
Is historically African and what is historically Christian, for instance, right. in the way the many of the burials are being discovered, and you have questions about you know, things like that that probably only a black historian would be able to decipher.
Yeah, yeah.
You see, and there's also a question about how they died. You know, most times they would tell you they died of natural causes. One concern, and I'm not saying this is to be a fact that it would be there, but you know, in 1741, there were rumors that there was going to be a slave uprising, and a great many black people were actually killed. And no one knows what happened to the bodies, where were they disposed. So one of the things they're looking for, too, is how people died. For instance, one body did disclose that there was a cannon, you know, not a cannon, but a, you know, a
kind of musket
a slug, you know, to show that that person had been killed rather than to have died. But from either stress or work, old age, or some kind of yeah. Many diseases that ran rampant at that particular time.
Now, isn't there something, I've heard something about a hanging spot or something that was near that burial ground?
Right. Well, see, that all these things we would like to you know, to find out, and we, since we have been victimized by what people have done with our history, it doesn't stand a reason for us to trust anybody else. So when we first went on that site, we didn't see anybody that was identifiable, you know, one of us, except for one person who looked suspicious.
Wow.
You know, so we
don't see that.
But the point is that later on, as a result of our interest, right. Now they're now reaching out, trying to circumvent our attempt to give input by saying, oh, we went and got somebody from Howard University,
right.
Or we got somebody from another school.
Right.
And what is happening, a lot of our people have not been versed or have taken up these disciplines, you know, of going into anthropology and archaeology. Well, there are some. Mm. And so therefore, what we're trying to do now is to reach out and find those people. For instance, like, say, Dr. Janetta Coles, who heads up, you know, Spelman College, is an anthropologist.
Okay.
And we've been trying to, you know, contact Janetta, who I know, and see if she would actually be interested in helping on this.
Mm.
But it is a major find. And so you have a contradiction where the scientists would like to be down there for years just going over this stuff, you know. The construction people have a problem because they want to get their building up.
Yeah.
So,
right.
you know, and then our contradiction is with both of them.
Yeah.
We got so much to talk about, and we have to break here for, you know, all of this reminds me of Roots.
Mm.
And you have a suite that's called Roots
the
Suite.
Roots Suite, yes.
Okay. We have your brother, Kwame Braithwaite.
Mm.
Kwame is a veteran fashion and music industry photographer and probably every other
kind
of photographer.
A movement photographer, too.
Yeah. And what do you say?
Movement photographer.
Movement photographer
yeah.
and community activist.
Yeah. Yeah.
We have some work that he did on some musicians. And we have the music of Noel Pointer. Noel, would you set up briefly something about your Roots Suite?
Well, the Roots Suite, I think, best sort of sums up my feelings when I think about the African burial ground.